Hello all, welcome back to I Love PhD. In this video, we are going to explore the 10 important types of plagiarism that every academic writer should know before writing a thesis or manuscript. Please watch the video till the end to get the complete detail. Also, don't forget to subscribe I Love PhD for more research related information. Let's get into the video. Plagiarism is the most common issue that every academic writer faces while writing their research paper or dissertation. This plagiarism is defined by a deliberate or reckless representation of another's work, thoughts, or ideas as one's without attribution in the connection with the submission of an academic work. The famous plagiarism checking tool Turnitin classifying this plagiarism into 10 major types. Let's check the first type of plagiarism. Cloning is the first type of plagiarism, which is also called identical copying. In this, one person copies another work word by word without any change and claim that work as its own work. So usually this happens when one person does not want to have a work on his own, but instead choose to use another's work and submit as its own work. As long as the first work had already submitted, this second work will automatically be detected by the plagiarism tool. Let's check the second one. The second type of plagiarism is a remix plagiarism. In this, one person collects information from various sources and mix all together as a single document. Then the person claims that work as its own work. This usually happens when persons source phrases from different sources then combine them to make a sentence or a paragraph. It simply means taking the written work from many sources and carefully combining that all the works, aligning them to make sense with the paragraph. From distance look, such work usually appear to be a professional and high quality until it is red flagged by the plagiarism tools. Let's check the third plagiarism type. The third type of plagiarism is called Ctrl plus C plagiarism. It's simply called copying plagiarism. It happens when, in the written document, a significant portion of a text copied from any single source without any alteration, then it is called a Ctrl plus C kind of plagiarism. This copy plagiarism is a type of plagiarism that happens when the person's work contains a large portion of texts from a single source. This is called Ctrl plus C plagiarism. Let's check the fourth one. Hybrid plagiarism is the fourth type of plagiarism, which happens when perfectly cited sources, documents are copied and arranged as a new document without citation. It usually occurs when one person combines perfectly cited sources with the copied passages without citation. It is a plagiarism that occurs due to the improper in-text citation. In most cases, this plagiarism occurs in a properly written body of work, but poor referencing. So this type of plagiarism is called hybrid plagiarism, and we'll check the fifth one. In the find and replace plagiarism, one person changing the most common keywords and phrases in the copied content and not making any changes in the essential document. This kind of plagiarism happens when one person changes the keywords and phrases and retain the essential content of the sources. A person who practices this kind of plagiarism is often believes that they can easily deceive the softwares by simply changing the keyword. But unfortunately, some advanced plagiarism tools will easily identify this kind of plagiarisms. Let's check the sixth kind of plagiarism. The sixth type of plagiarism is called recycled plagiarism. In this, it refers to act of borrowing one's own previous documents without proper citation. It's called lack of citation problem. This recycling plagiarism is a type of plagiarism that takes place when one person borrows heavily from previous person's work without putting proper citation. In the mashup type of plagiarism, a person will mix material content copied from multiple sources, and it simply shows that the student has done some research but has decided not to write the borrowed information. This mashup plagiarism appears in different colors when you take a report from the plagiarism tools. Let's check the eighth type of plagiarism. The eighth type of plagiarism is 404 error plagiarism. In this, a person creates a document by copying from various sources and prepares as a single document with the citation. But if the citation is inaccurate or it will lead to non-existing sources, then it will be called 404 type of plagiarism. So the plagiarism tools also verify whether all the cited documents are properly redirecting to the particular content. If it fails, then 404 error will be flagged by the plagiarism tools. Let's check the ninth type of plagiarism. In the aggregated type of plagiarism, the written document includes all the proper citation, but it does not contain original work. It is also related to 404 error plagiarism when a person takes a fake work but includes proper citation. If a person work with this cooked citation is often related to as a plagiarism and form of a academic cheating. Let's check the final type of plagiarism. The last and tenth type of plagiarism is called retweet plagiarism. In this, all the written documents seems perfect with properly cited mark, but still the document resembles somewhere the original text structure or wording, then it is called a retweet plagiarism. That's all about the 10 types of plagiarism. Hope this information will help you to improve your academic writing. Like and share this video. Also, don't forget to subscribe this channel. Thank you.